गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास. वंस अगेन वी आर बैक विद आवर हिस्ट्री चैप्टर नंबर 6, द कोलोनियलिज्म एंड द सिटी. आई बिलीव यू रिमेंबर व्हाट इज कोलोनियलिज्म. वी हैव ऑलरेडी लर्नड एंड वी आर सीइंग हाउ द व्हाट वाज द कंडीशन ऑफ द सिटीज एंड द कंट्री साइड ड्यूरिंग द टाइम ऑफ कॉलोनीज ड्यूरिंग द ब्रिटिश टाइम. दैट मीन्स वेन वी वेयर कॉलोनी टू द ब्रिटिशर्स. ओके, वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन दैट हाउ दिल्ली वॉज इमर्जिंग एज अ न्यू कैपिटल. What are the things that we have taken place already? We have seen. Let's see the making of New Delhi. That means we have already see how seen how old Delhi was actually all about. Now let's see the making of New Delhi. How Delhi is now as of now, or we'll see that how Delhi has been made as of now. So let's see the making. Okay. So the 1808, the 1803, the British gained control of Delhi after defeating the Marathas. So we all know that Maratha was one of the power that had captured almost major parts of India, including Delhi. And that time, even before the Delhi was in the control of Britishers, it was actually in the control of Marathas. So after defeating the Marathas, the Britishers gained the control in 1803. Since the capital of British India was Calcutta, which I have told you in the previous class, that before Delhi was made as the capital, it was Calcutta which was the capital of India. So the Mughal emperor was allowed to continue living in the palace complex in the Red Fort. So at that time, the Mughal emperor was living in the Red Fort during that time. The modern city as we know it today developed only after 1911, when Delhi became the capital of British India. So after that, 1911, what is today in Delhi is, that is what has happened, became the capital of British India. So demolishing a past, that means demolishing means destroying a past. So what it is, how we have broken or destroyed or entirely swept off the past. Before 1857, developments in Delhi were somewhat different from those in the other colonial cities. So we have many more colonial cities like Madras, Bombay, Calcutta, those are also colonial cities. But Delhi was developing little different than of them. So in Madras, Bombay or Calcutta, the living spaces of Indians and the British were sharply separated. So they were very sharply separated at the time, where Indians would stay and where Britishers would stay. The Indians lived in the black areas at the time. So yes, the Indians were known as blacks. Hence, there was a separated space for blacks. So that was black area where Indians were staying, while the British lived in the well laid off white areas. So in Delhi, especially in the first half of the 19th century, the British lived along with the wealthier Indians in the walled city. So the time in Delhi, the Britishers used to stay with the wealthy Indians with the walled city, and the British learned to enjoy Urdu, Persian culture and poetry and participate in local festivals. So now Britishers were enjoying with them, with the people, local people in Delhi, learning Urdu, Persian and the poetry, and also taking participate in the festivals. The great establishment of Delhi College in 1792 led to a great intellectual flowering in the sciences as well as humanities. The first Delhi College that was established in 1792, please underline this, this was actually the intellectual flowering. That means people were now becoming more intelligent in the field of science and humanities, largely in the Urdu language. Many refer to the period from 1830 to 1857 as a period of the Delhi Renaissance. Now, Renaissance means rebirth or revival, living into a new life. So that is the period, please underline, from 1830 to 1857 for Delhi Renaissance. See here, the Renaissance meaning is the literally rebirth or art of learning. It's a term often used to describe a time when there is a great creative activity happening. Gulfaroshan, that is a festival of flowers at the time. Okay. So all this changed after 1857. During the revolt that year, as we have seen, the rebels gathered in the city and persuaded Bahadur Shah to become the leader of this uprising. Delhi remained under rebel control for 4 months. So all of this changed after 1857. As the revolt has, 1857 revolt was there, 1847 uprising, 1857 national revolt. After the revolt, Bahadur Shah became the leader of their uprising, and Delhi remained under rebel control for 4 months. There was once a city of this name, Ghalib. This is a source too we have. Ghalib lamented the changes that were occurring and wrote sadly about the past. What I can write, the life of Delhi depends on the fort, Chani Chowk, the daily gatherings of the Jamuna Bridge and the annual Gulfaroshan. When all this, there were no longer, how can you live Delhi? how there was one city of the name in the dominations of India. So that was how Delhi was. And without all of this, what is Delhi all about? Delhi is all about the Chandni Chowk, the lighting, the Jamuna River and everything. That's what the Ghalib says. Ghalib is a poet, okay? Please remember that. Okay. So now continue with the class chapter. When the British regained the city, they embarked on a campaign of revenge and plunder. So the famous poet Ghalib witnessed the events of the time. This is how he describes the ransacking of Delhi in 1857. When the angry lions, that is the Britishers, entered the town, they killed the helpless and burned the house. Hordes of men and women, commoners and noblemen, poured out of Delhi from the three gates and took shelter in small communities and tombs outside the city. So that is how he described that when the Britishers came, they started killing the people, helpless people, burned houses, women, men, all were being killed. And these poor people left from three gates and they stayed outside the tombs of the city. To prevent another rebellion, the British exiled Bahadur Shah to Burma, now Myanmar. So this type of another rebellion should not start. So the Britishers made Bahadur Shah to leave India and move to Burma. Burma is today's Myanmar. Dismantled his court, razed several of the palaces, closed down gardens and built barracks for troops in the places. So he stopped all of this. King's palace closed them. Gardens were being closed and all of this were now becoming barracks for the soldiers. See, the old Delhi is what it is. The British wanted Delhi to forget its Mughal past. The area around the fort was completely cleared of gardens, pavilions and mosques. Though temples were left intact, the British wanted a clear ground for security reasons. So they started removing everything. All gardens, pavilions and mosques were being closed. Mosques in particular areas were either destroyed or put to other uses. For instance, Zinnat al-Masjid was converted into a bakery. No worship was allowed in the Jama Masjid for 5 years. One third of the city was demolished and its cannons were filled up. In 1870s, the western walls of Shahjahanabad were broken to establish the railway and to allow the city to expand beyond the walls. So that is how British started breaking down the walls and started a new city beyond the walls. Railway lines to be made. So British now began living in the sprawling civil lines area that came up in the north, away from the Indians in the walled city. Delhi College was turned into school and shut down in 1877. So this college was also being made and then shut down into school and then later on. So that's how. Now this is a planning of a new capital. So how this capital came into being, let's see. The British were fully aware of the symbolic importance of Delhi. After the revolt of 1857, many spectacular events were held there. In 1877, Viceroy Lytton organized a darbar to acknowledge Queen Victoria as the Empress of India. So that time, 1877, Viceroy Lytton organized a darbar at the time where when Queen Victoria came to India, she was the Empress of India at the time. Remember that Calcutta was still the capital of British India, but the Grand Darbar was being held in Delhi. Why was this so? During the revolt, the British had realized that the Mughal Emperor was still important to the people and they saw them their leader. So it was therefore important to celebrate British power with pomp and show the city of Mughal Emperors had earlier ruled and the place which had turned into a rebel stronghold in 1857. So that's just they wanted to show the Mughal power where it was in Delhi is now no more remains a power. Now it is in the hands of the Britishers. So instead of celebrating all of those things in the capital Calcutta at the time, they started celebrating in Delhi. So in 1911, when King George V was crowned in England, a darbar was held in Delhi to celebrate this occasion. So the decision to shift the capital of India from Calcutta to Delhi was announced at this darbar. New Delhi was constructed as a 10 square mile city on a Rasina hill. South of the existing city, two architects, Edward Lutyens and Herbert Baker, were called on to design New Delhi as its building. Even today, if you go to Rajpath Mark in Delhi, okay, at present, you will find there both the sites, North Block and South Block. This all of this historical government buildings where still today our government work in the North Block and in the South Block buildings, and entirely straight if you move in that hill, raising hill, you will find the Rashtrapati Bhavan is where once the Queen Elizabeth used to stay. before you enter, before that road starts, you will find there's a wall. In that, this two persons' name is written, two architects' name, Edward Lewton and Herbert Baker. These were the two architects, important name in the history of New Delhi. They have built that entire area. He is the architect. Please underline those names, which are very important. The government complex in New Delhi consists of the 2 Mile Avenue. That is what I am talking about. Okay, this is what exactly is. This is the North Block and this is the South Block. And here, this place has that wall where you have these names of written of Lieutenant and Baker, these two architects of India, of that. And this is what is the Rashtrapati Bhavan. You can see it's a huge long way route. You have to walk around to visit. If you ever get a chance to visit Delhi, please do visit it. Kingsway, now Rajpath, that was known as. Kingsway, which we today known as Rajpath, has led to the Viceroy's Palace, now known as Rashtrapati Bhavan, with the secretariat buildings on either sides of the avenues. Two sides you will find it. The features of these government buildings were borrowed from different periods of India's imperial history, but the overall look was classical Greece, 5th century BCE. So for instance, the central dome of the Viceroy's Palace was copied from the Buddhist stupa at Sanchi, and the red sandstone and carved screens of or jalis were borrowed from Mughal architecture. But the new buildings had to assert British importance. That is why the architect made sure the Viceroy's Palace was higher than the Shah Jahan's Jama Masjid. So that is how it is. Jama Masjid's height is still less than the Viceroy's Palace, that is Rashtrapati Bhavan. How was this to be done? So New Delhi took nearly 20 years to build. The idea was to build a city that was a stark contrast to Shahjahanabad. There were no crowded mohallas, no mazes of narrow bylanes in New Delhi. There were to be broad, straight streets lined with sprawling mansions set in the middle of large compounds. The architects actually wanted New Delhi to represent a sense of law and order, in contrast to the chaos of old Delhi. The new city also had to be clean and healthy space. The British saw overcrowded spaces as unhygienic and unhealthy, the source of disease. This means that New Delhi have to have better water supply, sewage disposal and drainage facilities than the old city. It had to be green with trees and parks, ensuring fresh air and adequate supply of oxygen. So that was the difference, how old Delhi is what filthy, dirty, bylanes, crowded mohallas and narrow lanes. So that does not want, they don't want them to be like that. So they wanted New Delhi to be a very new one, a very clean, green and a very big city. That is what is the vision of them. So that is the vision of New Delhi. This is how Viceroy Harding explained the choice of Delhi as a capital. He says that a change would strike the imagination of the people of India, would be accepted by all, the assertion of an unflattering determination to maintain British rule in India. The architect Herbert Baker, he believed that the new capital must be the sculptural monument of the good government and the unity which India for the first time in its history has enjoyed under British rule. The British rule in India is not mere a vinegar of government and culture, but also it is a new civilization in growth, a blend of the best element of East and West. It is to be the great fact that the architecture of Delhi should bear testimony. That is what he said. Now the life in the time of partition is where we will do in the next class. By the time, I'll stop here. Let's move to the exercise question. Let's see what it is there for your exercise. We have already done with 3 true or false. Yes. Now the 4th and the 5th you have to do. Fill in the blanks. First one, second one, third one. Third one, okay. Identify 3 differences in the city design of New Delhi and Shahjahanabad.